Welcome to another session of grade 9 mathematics, chapter 2, polynomials. Dear students, in this part 8 and the last part of the chapter, we shall further understand the application of algebraic identities and try to solve NCERT exercise 2.5, question number 9 to question number 16. Let's solve question number 9. So question number 9 says, verify the first question, x cube plus y cube is equal to x plus y into x square minus xy plus y square. This is actually an identity, but then we have been asked to verify. So how shall I supposed to do? How shall we do that? Yes. What I've done over here is taken my RHS, that is right hand side of the equation, which is x plus y into x square minus xy plus y square, and then multiply the brackets. So first x gets multiplied with the bracket, that is x square minus xy plus y square, and then plus y also gets multiplied with the bracket, x square minus xy plus y square. So as you could see in the fourth line of the solution for the first question, what am I getting? X cube minus x square y plus xy square plus x square y minus xy square. Now, when on simplification, what will happen is minus x square y and plus x square y gets cancelled out. Similarly, xy square and minus xy square also gets cancelled out. So what am I left with? I'm left with x cube plus y cube, which is actually my LHS. So RHS is now equal to LHS. Hence, we have verified the first question. Similarly, the second question is to verify x cube minus y cube is equal to x minus y into x square plus xy plus y square. So as I did in the first question, over here too, I'll take the RHS and solve it further. So my RHS is x minus y into x square plus xy plus y square. As I did with the previous sum, I'll multiply my x with the entire bracket. So x is multiplied with x square plus xy plus y square. And then minus y also gets multiplied with x square plus xy plus y square. Now, as you can see in the fourth line of the solution for question number 2, what do I have? X cube plus x square y plus xy square minus x square y minus xy square minus y cube. And on simplification, x plus x square y and minus x square y gets cancelled out. Plus xy square and minus xy square gets cancelled out. So what am I left with is x cube minus y cube, which is actually my LHS. So over here again too, the RHS and LHS are equal to one another on solving. Hence, we have verified the question. So I hope you all have understood how to do question number 9. Let us utilize this identity, that is x cube plus y cube, and the second identity, that is x cube minus y cube, to solve question number 10. So question number 10 says, factorize each of the following. And the first question is 27y cube plus 125z cube. Can you please resemble this question to the identity on the right side of the screen? Please do that. Yes, 27y cube can be written as 3y the whole cube. And 125z cube can be written as pi z the whole cube. So once I write 3y the whole cube plus pi z the whole cube, it is exactly resembling x cube plus y cube. So what would my x be? Here x will be 3y and y will be pi z. So all that I have to do is replace the value of x and y as 3y and pi z respectively in the identity x plus y into x square minus xy plus y square, which will give me the answer as 3y plus 5z, which makes up my first bracket, and then 9y square minus 15yz plus 25z squared. Isn't that easy? Yes. Now let's do the second question. The second question is 64m cubed minus 343n cubed. Isn't it very similar to the first question? But yes, here it belongs to the identity x cube minus y cube. So what is my x? Yes, as you could see over here, 64m cube has been written as 4m the whole cube. So x is 4m, and 343n cube has been written as 7n the whole cube. So my y is 7m. So I've got x cube minus y cube. That is 4m the whole cube minus 7n the whole cube. So I have realized what is my x and y. What will x be replaced by? 4m. And what will y be replaced of my identity? By 7m. So simply putting 4m and 7m n in place of x and y in the identity, I'll get my final answer, which is 4m minus 7n, and the next bracket, 16m squared plus 28mn plus 49m squared. Isn't that easy? Very interesting too? Yes. I hope you're clear with the solutions for question number 10. If that's the case, let me take you to question number 11. Here, we have an altogether new identity applied over here. The identity that is used to solve question number 11 is x cube plus y cube plus z cube minus 3xyz is equal to x plus y plus z, x square plus y square plus z square minus xy minus yz minus xz. So, as you can see in the identity, the left hand side of the identity is very similar. I mean, the question that we have is very similar to the left hand side of the identity, isn't it? The identity has four terms on the left hand side, and even our question has four terms on the as 27x cubed plus y cubed plus z cubed minus 9xyz. Let us actually check it whether it actually resembles exactly the same way or not. So 27x cubed can be written as 3x the whole cube plus y cubed can be written as y the whole cube plus z cubed can be written as z the whole cube. So I've got my x, y and z. Yes, let me put that in minus 3xyz. So 3 into x will be replaced by 3x, y as it is, and z also becomes as it is. And you realize that it actually resembles to the identity x cube plus y cube plus z cube minus 3xyz. So all that you have to do is replace the value of x, y and z in the identity. X will be replaced by 3x, y will remain as the same, and z will remain as z itself. So when you solve it, the final answer that you'll be getting is 3x plus y plus z, and the next bracket, 9x squared plus y squared plus z squared minus 3xy minus yz minus 3xz. I hope that is clear to everyone. Yes. Now let us look into the further application of this identity in question number 12. Now, question number 12, as it appears on the screen, seems to be a lot of calculation, but my dear, don't worry, it's an easy one. And an important one from the examination point of view also. Here, question number 2 says, verify that x cube plus y cube plus z cube minus 3xyz is equal to half into x plus y plus z into the brackets x minus y the whole square plus y minus z the whole square plus z minus x the whole square. Now for the verification part, what I've done first is taken the RHS. And if you could see, I've rewritten the RHS first as part of the first line of the solution. In the second line, half into x plus y plus z remains as it is. What I've done is, the second part of the bracket is solved further. That is, x minus y the whole square is solved as x squared minus 2xy plus y squared plus y minus z the whole square is solved as y squared minus 2yz plus z square, and z minus x the whole square is solved as z square minus 2zx plus x square. Now, in the third line of the solution, all that I did is just open up the brackets. That is, half x plus y plus z remains as it is. The second part of the bracket is opened up. So there could be a change in sign or it could not be. Just open up the bracket and solve it. And the fourth line of the solution, you will realize that half x plus y plus z is written as it is. The second part of the bracket, if you could simplify, you will find that x square, there are two x squares. So x square plus x square gives me 2x square. Y square plus y square gives me 2y square. And z square plus z square gives me 2z square. What is left out? It's minus 2xy, minus 2yz, and minus 2zx. Don't you think that there is something common to all the terms in the second bracket? Yes, 2 is common to all of them. So that's what I've done in the next step. Half into x plus y plus z, and then taking 2 out common. So what will happen in the bracket? What will be left out is x square plus y square plus z square minus xy minus yz minus zx. So the 2 of half, that is 1 upon 2, the denominator 2, and the 2 outside the bracket gets cancelled out. Because they are, one of them is denominator, the other one is in the numerator. So what am I left with? X plus y plus z into x square plus y square plus z square minus xy minus yz minus zx. Which is actually an identity and equal to x cube plus y cube plus z cube minus 3xyz. This is the identity that we have discussed for question number 11 also. Isn't that clear enough to everyone? Yes. Practice this well, you'll be able to get the solution. It is all about that the calculation involved is a bit too much, but then they're easy to do it. So practice well question number 12. Let us utilize this identity further in question number 13. Which says that if x plus y plus z is equal to 0, show that x cube plus y cube plus z cube is equal to 3xyz. So as part of the solution, I'll write the identity first, which is x cube plus y cube plus z cube minus 3xyz is equal to x plus y plus z into x square plus y square plus z square minus xy minus yz minus xz. Now, as it is given in the question that x plus y plus z is equal to 0. Isn't it? So, in the formula or in the identity itself, I'll replace x plus y plus z by the number 0. So, in the RHS, if you find 0 into the bracket, that is x square plus y square plus z square minus xy minus yz minus xz, my dear, 0 into anything would be 0. So, what am I left with is x cube plus y cube plus z cube minus 3xyz is equal to 0. And if I take minus 3xyz to the right hand side, I'm left with x cube plus y cube plus z cube is equal to 3xyz, which is actually what we want as part of the question. Isn't it simple? Yes. So this was solution to question number 13. Let us further use this understanding of question number 13 to solve question number 14. So question number 14 is very important from examination point of view also, wherein it says that without actually calculating the cubes, find the value of each of the following. So what is the first one? Minus 12 cube plus 7 cube plus 5 cube. So what are they saying over here is, you're not supposed to do the cube of 12, do the cube of 7, do the cube of 5 and then add it. No, that's not the way. But then they're expecting us to use an identity. Now which one? If you could see on the right hand side, I have written if x plus y plus z is equal to 0, then we can show that x cube plus y cube plus z cube is equal to 3xyz, which is what we have solved over here. Yes. So I just verified as part of the first step of the solution that x plus y plus z is equal to 0 actually. Because minus 12 plus 7 plus 5 when solved gives me 0. So if x plus y plus z is equal to 0, then what is x cube plus y cube plus z cube? It is 3xyz. So that means minus 12 cube plus 7 cube plus 5 cube will be 3xyz. That is 3 into minus 12 into 7 into 5. Which when solved gives me minus 1260. Likewise, we can do the second sum also, which is 28 whole cube plus minus 15 whole cube plus minus 30 whole cube. The same way as we did the first question. First, checking out whether x plus y plus z is equal to 0, that is 28 plus minus 15 plus minus 13 is 0 or not. And if it is 0, simply putting the value 3xyz, that is 3 into x into y into z, that is 3 into 28 into minus 15 into minus 13, which happens to be 16,380. Yes, you could just see how a single identity, algebraic identity, is used in different manners to solve different kind of sums. Isn't it? Yes. Let us quickly solve the remaining two sums. Question number 15, which says give possible expressions for the length and the breadth of each of the following rectangles in which the area is given. So the area for the first question is given as 25a squared minus 35a plus 12. What I've done over here is middle term splitting, which we have learned thoroughly in the previous sessions. So when middle term splitting is done, I get the answer as pi a minus 3 and pi a minus 4. One of them is length, the other one is breadth. Isn't it easy? Yes. Likewise, the second question also, the area is given as 35y squared plus 13y minus 12. Again, middle term splitting, which gives me the answer as 7y minus 3 and 5y plus 4, wherein one of them can be taken as length and the other one will be taken as breadth. Is it a very similar question to question number 15 is question number 16. Here, the volume is given and I have been asked to find the dimension. That is, volume of a cuboid would have dimensions such as length, breadth and height. So all that I have to do is factorize it further. The first question is, the volume is 3x squared minus 12x. I try to factorize it. What do I get? 3x outside the bracket, and in the bracket I have x minus 4. So basically it is 3 into x minus 4. So one of them would be length, the other one would be breadth, and the last one would be height. Yes, simply factorize the given question. Likewise, I've done with the second question also, wherein the volume is 12ky square plus 8ky minus 20k. Now to solve this, my dear students, I've done an additional step. That is, taking the common factor to all of them. What is it? 4k. 4k is common to all the three terms. So when 4k is taken out, what am I left with? I'm left with 3y squared plus 2y minus 5. And then you middle term split 3y squared plus 2y minus 5. As you could see, what do I get in the last step is, along with 4k, I get 3y plus 5 and y minus 1. So I've got three factors and they can be taken as the dimensions of the cuboid. One of them will be length, the other one will be breadth, and the last one will be height. So with this, we come to the end of exercise 2.5 as well as to the end of chapter 2 polynomials. Make sure you practice well, especially exercise 2.5, which has the application of all the different type of algebraic identities. This is all for now. Take care of yourself until we meet next time with another session, with another chapter. Till then, take care. Bye.